says in his book, Guerrilla Warfare, there is no prescribed method of struggle. Every method will depend on the circumstances that exist at that point in time. In 2 days' time, the nation will know what course of action we are going to take. I can't print here, I'm sorry. That a Guru Constitutional Court, Rara Sanya Yedu, Yekuti, delimitation, I can't tell Nezek, Aisipam Demo. Aina kuenda kunotarisa kuti zvii chaizvo zvatichitaura yangoti iyo haina simba rekunzwa nyaya yedu semaunzira yataiita saka zviripo ndezvokuti isu hatiwi run nemutongo waitwa neconstitutional court zviri pachena kuti waita political judgment vateerera mafaction emamwe mapato zviri pachena izvozvo saka isu seMDC hatisi kuzokumira ipapo hatisi kuzozorora kusvika delimitation report yakaitwa nezeki yabviswa kana kuti yaitwa revised saka tichazozivisa veruzhinji nezvatichaita sebato reMDC.
Hello gorgeous people, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Uncensored with Rumbi. All right, so guys, I'm asking you to subscribe to the channel if you're new to the family, but if you're not new to the family, if you're regular, I just want to say shout out to you because today is a beautiful day, right? We're going to be looking at Mr. Monzora, who definitely lost today in the Constitutional Court. And then we're going to move to my sister, Sisidanga Rembwa. Both of their convictions have been acquitted. All right. And then we're going to move into one of the most interesting stories, that the CIO are now in charge of elections. Okay, so award-winning journalist Hope Ochingon actually reported that the Constitutional Court has dismissed the application by MDCT President Douglas Monzora seeking to stop the elections and declare the delimitation report by ZIC invalid. This means the election is going ahead as planned between July 26th and August 26th, 2023. So now the game is now on. As between ZANU-PF official, the ruling party, and the alternative, the Citizen Coalition for Change, the President Nelson Chamisa. It's going to be such an interesting year this year. So I just can't wait, guys, please, I'm asking you, right? I definitely flew to Zimbabwe, did I tell you to register to vote? And today you can see I'm wearing yellow, so which means my party is ready for elections. We are working harder. We'll do everything in our power to make sure that we win this election without a shadow of a doubt. So I want to tell you guys to run in your numbers. For those that has not registered to vote, please do. Please do. It's one thing to complain. It's when you know that you played your part and then you have the right to actually speak up, right? So I'm expecting you guys to go in your numbers and register to vote. I'm super, super excited. I can't wait really to cast my vote. So guys, to Mr. Monzora right now, I want to say cheers. Cheers to Mr. Monzora. Right, we're just gonna have water. All right, so guys, I'm so excited. Let me tell you something. I didn't find any reason why Monzora wanted to actually stop elections. First and foremost, you literally fought to get everything for the opposition party when it used to be MDC, and you got it. But let me just say, life doesn't work that way. It doesn't. You know, sometimes we feel like we're in control, but there's actually one person who's in control. Yahweh, God Almighty. You know, when he says yes, no man can ever say no. I'm super excited. I really can't wait to see what God has in store for us. I think all of you are waiting, right? Great. And so now, here we are. All right. Please register to vote. Please do. Youth, young people, take charge. Imagine, I had to flew from here to say, I need to make sure that I take charge of my future right here. I expect you to do the same. Exactly, I expect you to do the same. So I'm going to move to our next story, please. It's Sisidanga Rembwa, and he co-accused or co-convicted, Julie Barnes. So there were reports today that Zimbabwe's internationally acclaimed writer and filmmaker, Sisidanga Rembwa, and her friend Julie Barnes have been acquitted by the High Court, and they had their bogus conviction thrown out today in Harare. So it was a bogus conviction. For the journalist, they were falsely convicted by Magistrate Barbara Mateko on an incitement charge when they had a two-woman march demanding reforms and my release from prison in July 2020. So literally this was for Hope Watching On, actually, when he was arrested. So they were demanding that we need reforms. We are tired of bogus charges for people being incarcerated, even though they are not guilty, you know? And again, are you surprised? I am not. So the matter was thrown out today by Justice Happier Shaw and Justice Benjamin Chikwawero. Zimbabwe's magistrates courts have seen many opposition politicians, government critics and journalists denied bail on bogus grounds, convicted on false facts and remanded for years on defective charges as a form of political persecution. The matter was argued by one of Zimbabwe's senior lawyers, Harrison Goma. So then the conviction was acquitted in the High Court. I'm in shock. That's just holding a placard and campaigning for your party. Like, not for your party, but just saying, we want reforms. We are tired of seeing innocent people being thrown into prison. I didn't know that that was actually a crime. But I'm so glad, really. I want to say congratulations and also thank you to the attorney who stood by them, who did his great work, the advocate. Thank you for your hard work. And my sisters, thank you. I'm super excited for you, Titsi and Julie, that you are finally free and your names are cleared. It's just hard, guys, to live with a conviction of something you know you never did. It's really hard. And I'm praying for my sisters, well, Fadzeh Maheri, that God is going to come through for her. My brothers, too. So we have Jacob Ngari Vuma and also have... so next one, we were too, you know, but all these three people, God should come through for them and just free them. I had to live with the conviction, and I don't think that anyone would want that on their name. I just can't wait to see these people free. I'm sorry to say that, I can't wait to see them free, but I'm really excited, and thank you to all the attorneys and also the magistrates who really stood up for truth and free the people. I want to say shout out to you for doing your job, because you are the people that we need in the next Zimbabwe. The new Zimbabwe needs only the people who are doing right. You know what I mean? Yes, the new Zimbabwe is right around the corner. I tell you, it's around the corner. Now we're moving to our last story. Okay. When I read this article, I was literally like, wow. You know, I thought all along Zek is actually in control of elections. So as per the report, that they are ahead of the news curve. Okay, so we are ahead of the news curve. Of course, we're here. CIO takes overrunning of elections from the army. CIO takes overrunning of elections from the army. So the army was running elections. I thought that was Zek. The Zimbabwe Electoral Commission. Okay, to this one again, cheers. Cheers, guys. Huh? I didn't know actually that the army was running elections all along. I didn't know that, and I was like flabbergasted, like, yo, this is crazy. The CIO takes over the running of elections from the military. Wow, guys, yo, I can't believe this. All along, guys, the military were running elections. So what was Zek doing? How many people are just waiting to see what's going to happen? How many people are waiting to cast their votes? Because again, I'm going to remind you to register to vote. The youth, run in your numbers. Run in your numbers. You need to register to vote. I mean, you can actually see that something must be wrong somewhere. Yeah. Because from the army running elections to the CIO running elections. All right, guys, this is just unbelievable. But you know, one thing that I believe in is that Panim is scripture saying, I don't know, Father, I think I can share that with you. I love to say it in Shona because it's easier for people to get it. But I know some people may not understand, but trust me, it's the most beautiful scripture. It says, as Maketa Jesenda Kanyara. But Ndichaku Vambrai. Yo, this is deep. And my mom likes to talk about this scripture a lot. But I think it's so important for people to note that you may do whatever you're doing, but there's that day where God says it's enough. The buck stops right here, you know? And let me just tell y'all. And I was laughing with someone. I was like, we are like the children of Israel, guys. We have passed 40 years. You know, the children of Israel, 40 years. But we have passed 40 years. Literally, God has such a huge purpose with this country. We are like, God has to use Zimbabwe in Africa to show that this is who I am. And I want to show you my power. So I can't wait. I really can't wait to see what God has in store for us. Because we are literally, I've heard people saying, oh, Smith was better. How many people have heard that? Yeah, let me tell you. And you also have seen people online say that. The children of Israel said exactly the same. They said, Moses, take us back to Pharaoh. They were crying for slavery. That's what all of you are doing. But let me just say this, never do that. You don't deserve slavery. You deserve peace and love and unity. So trust me, in front of you where you are right now, you're very close. Don't cry for slavery because you're really very close to the finish line. I'm super, super excited. Can't really wait to see what God is in store. But what God is in store is very close to freedom. All right, guys, tell me what you think in the comment section below.